As I creep up on the big 50,000 subscriber mark, which in reality means nothing to most everyone everywhere, I figured I'd put on the brakes a bit and review some flashlights. So today's video film is going to be for the budget lightform slash the lightform designed and Lumintop mass-produced FW series. And what that means is that the flashlight manufacturers by themselves can't design a decent flashlight if their life depended on it. So some people got together, mostly a guy named Fritz and a woman legally named Toykeeper, to collaborate on features and specs and tell Lumintop what makes a good flashlight. And if that sounds backwards, well, it kinda is. The models we're looking at specifically here are kind of all variants on the same design. They are small, everyday carry-sized lights with electronic tail cap switches that have a common operation and a pocket clip. You can choose from many variations of tints, from warm to neutral to cool white, and the materials the lights are made of, you know, in emitter style, single or triple LEDs. The three lights reviewed here are the standard aluminum FW3A, which I bought in a warm emitter early this year, and then the bead blasted raw copper neutral white tinted FW3A variant, released this summer, and then the single emitter cool white tinted FW1A. Let's say that was released this summer too. The copper and the FW1A were provided by Neil at Neil's Gadgets for review. Now as you see here, the copper one, when new, has a nice bead blasted texture. Look at that. Yeah. Slowly takes on the charm of old pennies you have fond memories of, like an old roll of pennies. Yeah, look at that. And again, one more time, a big thanks to Neil for his patience because I've had these for months now. However, if I call it long-term testing instead of procrastination, it all makes it seem better, right? So the tints to some people may seem complicated, and if you don't know shit about tint buying, let me break it down. Know that tint is described in temperatures, Kelvin. The warmer the tint, the lower the K number. The cooler, the higher the K. Now to confuse you, there's another way to look at tints, at least how they're described in product descriptions. Here are some blank stare-inducing numbers right here. The lower the number, like the 1A here, the cooler. The higher the number is warmer, or lower on the Kelvin, right? 1 is cool, 3 is neutral, 7 is the warmest. And talking about either at parties or gatherings will guarantee you won't get invited to those gatherings in the future. Output levels will make this section easy for all three lights. This review is going to be long. I have them all set to the smooth ramping, meaning they don't use individual levels. Emitter options affect output levels, of course. On Moon, my original FW3A with a warm emitter has the lowest of the moonlight modes. Then the smooth ramp up to high gives you the following three levels. You know, not three levels, but one for each light. And on Turbo, the obvious winner is the copper triple. These are my tested figures, they're estimates only. I'm stupid, sloppy with my testing methods, and not good at math, so please treat them appropriately. Okay, user interface, or as regular viewers know it, a reminder to use hand lotion. First, put in the battery. The positive goes towards the lens like a normal light, except Lumintop recommends you unscrew the head instead of the tail cap, you know, as to be not completely normal. The UI here is programmed by Toykeeper and one of the most advanced in a light. However, she has made the basic operation simple, so you can loan it to idiots. Or maybe you're an idiot. I'll not go into all the details, but I will cover the basics, how it comes out of the box, etc. Furthermore, an ergo to a Fortnite. It has a simple dimming scale. To get to the lowest output from off, the shortcut is press and hold. Release when it gets to the brightness you want or appropriate for the crime you're committing. Press and it goes all the way up to brightness. Release whenever you want. Now, quick release and press, here we go, goes the opposite way. A double click while on gets you to turbo, and from off, if you want turbo, turn it on, then double click. So, double click while on goes to turbo, two double clicks while off goes to turbo. Okay. Then 15 clicks activates invincibility. Since these lights have an electronic switch that on some models is touchy, the lockout is important. Click 4 times from off and it locks out. That means it only goes to a low momentary on and won't burn a hole in your tactical man purse. Click 4 times to get back to regular operation, or your tactical woman purse. Also, something I've found is a tail or head isn't fully cranked down. Sometimes the LEDs will rapidly flicker, or sometimes the brightness looks flaky. It's like jumps around a little bit, and you think it's broken, but it ain't. It's especially important on the copper one. Make sure the head, make sure the lens, and make sure the tail where the clip is are all cranked down. Like not overcranked, but you know, not where you can crank it anymore. And then to get to like the regular flashlight stepped brightness modes, three clicks gets you to stepped operation while on. I will not show you how to do any further programming, however, it has blinking modes that mimic candlelight. Then there's the thermal configuration that will allow it to hold high modes for longer, as long as you can handle holding it. The Muggle mode, yeah, like Harry Potter, which is 6 clicks from off, keeps it from getting over 300 lumens or so. And with that, I broke my promise about not getting into the bullshit any further. Runtimes, which is sort of appropriately named for the amount of viewers I lose right now, they all run. For this section, we just doing the turbo on all three lights using a Sony VTC6 high drain battery. In the frame, you see a clock denoting runtime and how you've wasted your time, and a lux meter showing if the light dims or brightens. And through some calculator heavy math, because I can't do it in my head, I estimate basic lumen and output levels over the course of the time, using percentages and whatnot. That could be wrong, of course. First, turbo on the copper performs best in the first minute. Sound familiar? I measured 3,471 lumens at startup. Within 30 seconds, we hit 880 lumens. 1 minute, we're down to 516 lumens, and by 5 minutes, we settle in at about 250 lumens. Now, it fluctuates between 250, 240, 230 lumens until close to the four-hour mark. In case your wife or friend ask who is listening in very intently while you're watching your flashlight content. But that's still a lot of light, 240 lumens. Anything over 1,000 lumens in lights this small is overkill. 4.5 hours, it raises to about 330 lumens. Not sure why, who cares? Before it starts dimming to about 11 lumens around 4 hours, 50 minutes, then low light, sublumen, until I kill the test after 5 hours. Ending voltage on the FW3A copper is 2.68 volts. Now, because we can't make it any worse, the triple aluminum startup I estimate is 2,106 lumens. 30 seconds in, we hit 725 lumens. 1 minute, 543 lumens. 5 minutes, we're doing about 292 lumens. 10 minutes in, we hit 120 lumens, and we fluctuate over the next few hours from a low of 115 and up into the 140s for an hour or two. Although we're using Sony VTC6 batteries, different types and tints of emitters, and different heat dissipation properties of copper versus aluminum will affect runtimes and outputs. Then we have a high of 183 lumens at 4 hours and 3 minutes before dropping to 12 lumens. Around 5 hours and hitting a sublumen mode when I finish the test, ending voltage is about 2.90 volts on the battery, with light still coming out. Finally, the FW1A, everyone exclaims in unison. I know, it's my favorite runtime of the three. Startup is estimated at 1,508 lumens. 30 seconds, 860 lumens. 1 minute, 500 lumens. 5 minutes, 292 lumens. 10 minutes in, we settle in at 250 lumens for quite a while. You know the main difference in these light happens under the first 30 seconds on all three of them? The thermal regulation kicks in because it's so much heat to get rid of for a tiny light. You know, it kind of makes you wonder what's the point. I mean, lumens-wise, not universe-wise, because they're only bright for a few seconds. 3 hours, 52 minutes, we have creeped back up to 311 lumens. Then after 4 hours, we see that big drop in brightness. Anyway, however, it's emergency mode light until the sublumen node hits at 10 hours. Ending voltage was about 2.7 sexy volts. Beam shock comparisons. Now we have a Zebralight, the Emisar, and an Olight, and of course the Lumintops. A mixture of tints and beam profiles here, compared here at startup brightness, with fresh batteries all around. Two of the FW3As are floody because they have frosted optics. Gives you a nice fade from the hotspot to the spill. Good for closer stuff and not throw. So a great EDC. First, the copper FW3A. Neutral, white, good tint, great everyday carry light. Neutral white is probably the most pleasing all-around tint to most people. You know, in theory, if this weren't a niche hobby. Oh, you know what? Okay, really, no one cares. Now the original aluminum triple. This is a warm tinted light, close to old incandescent flashlights, and I like it. Hey, when I say warm tint, does anyone else think of pee? Oh, okay, good, I'm the only one. Not as high of a turbo as the other FW3A, but who cares? Now you don't have to look too close, but you can see it start to step down and dim here. You can of course always double click to reset turbo for a few more seconds of stupid brightness. Now the single emitter, but throwier FW1A. It's small, but it achieves its spottiness via a reflector and a high-intensity emitter. A cool white tint for maximum throw and output on a single. Now back to the neutral white FW3A copper. Again, you can see a bit further with the FW1A, but I prefer an everyday carry with a more dispersed beam pattern for closer illumination. Now a zebra light. It's throwier, warmier, tintier, and spottier. I've had this for years now, and I honestly prefer the recessed side switch of a Zebralight to the tail caps of the FW series from Lumintop. Zebralight's electronic switch is the best. Now another old favorite, the copper Olight S2. Cool tint, wider spot, mellow or high. The S2 has been a pretty reliable beam shot comparison light over the years, so that's cool. Got this from Going Gear. Back to the copper FW3A for a sec. You know, just for comparisons. Now the Emisar D4, a purer white than the slightly rosy tint of the FW3A. I believe it's a Nietzsche here. I don't have a super strong preference of white. You know, white tinted neutral whites that I like better. Perhaps you do, and perhaps I don't really care why. Now let's look at the FW1A, since it has a different beam profile compared to the Zebralight here. Both are kind of spotty. The Zebralight has the older, less programmable UI, and I like the simplicity of the newer Narsal firmware on the Lumintops. Although I do like the new Zebralight's UI better than Narsal, but that's something else. Now versus the Olight S2. Not quite as throwy. I think I like the Olight's beam profile better. Finally, the Emisar. Now this is kind of dragging on, isn't it? I mean, what do we expect, you know? Imagine riding it. Okay, the warm tinted, yep, flashlight. And we're gonna go scroll through the next tier. And then we're gonna go to the Zebralight for a second, since we've seen it already. And back to the Lumintop. Pause. Emisar. Lumintop. Awkward pause. Olight. Is that it? Have we compared them all? Wrapping it up. Okay, so the Emisars and Lumintops are probably the closest competitors of the compared flashlights. If I had to break it down, it would be, do you prefer tail cap switches or side ones? The Emisars are about $40 to $50, and the Lumintops are about $45 to $50, depending on emitter options for the aluminum. And, I guess 70 for the copper and titanium. I don't know. They get a little more expensive when you use the finer materials. I've included a 20% off code down below. I don't know when it expires. Don't care. Two of these lights were provided by Neil's Gadgets. One of them I pre-ordered. Anyway, Neil used to work at Banggood, so now he has his own site. And I don't even have my own site. I found between the three lights here, the copper had a feather touch switch. The original FW3A had a nicer click. The first one I got, the warmer tinted one. There's some delay to off, and I'll be honest, I've had quite a few Lumintop lights over the years, and several have had switch fitment or click behavioral problems. I did try adjusting the retaining ring to make it feel a bit clickier on the copper, and didn't work. And I've been talking about switches for a whole paragraph, so joke's on me. I mean, it's on you too. So the machining on the lights is great. The UI is awesome if you want to spend some time working with it. There's nothing that interests me less than setting the thermal regulation to prolong the turbo a few seconds longer. So there's that. The Emisars and these Lumintops are the budget lights I'd recommend if anybody's looking for them. Personally, if I were to pick one out, I'd take a triple in titanium and a warm tint because it's a little lighter than the copper. Copper's heavier. Or, you know what, you can go with the aluminum if you don't have other flashlight nerds to impress. Of course, my favorite everyday carry lights are Zebralights, which often have uglier tints and are more expensive. And then there's Olights. You know, Olights are pretty good. I don't like the UI as much. So if you like the sort of video where a guy speaks 2,100 words about a flashlight, congratulations. Make sure you like, subscribe, follow me on Instagram, buy through the links below, comment. You can even buy a t-shirt. I wouldn't, you know, because of course I already have one. These all directly help support whatever this 15 minutes of content can be best described as. Here are my Patreons. Thank them. I thank them. You can be like them too. Just sign up over there and donate a dollar or two a month. So, thanks to them a whole lot. Thanks to you. Thanks for watching.